brings a part of himself to this, to each parent, and will form an integral part of this new family. We gather this day to bless this union in God's name. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, this is the day of new beginnings. Let us be glad and rejoice. Gracious God, we give you thanks for the decision that Scott and Chrissy have made to encourage each other in marriage. May this wedding day simply be a celebration of their new beginning as they journey into the future with hope and with love. Let us be glad and rejoice. May the love they have for each other ever make Christ new in their hearts. And may their love for each other and for Christ grow with each passing day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered together in the sight of God to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate. It is instituted by God, signifying unto us the spiritual union that is between Christ and his church. Christ blessed marriage with his presence and his first miracle in Cana of Galilee. Marriage is commended in the scriptures to be honorable among all, and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but entered into reverently, discreetly, soberly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two people come now to be joined. Who will give this woman to be married to this man? Love Scott and Chrissy in their new relationship accept their love and protection? If so, answer, we will. I want to share some scripture with you this evening. It's from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. And many of you are familiar with these scriptures. And Paul wrote this to the church in Corinth, encouraging them to love each other. The words he wrote are these: love is patient, love is kind, and is not jealous. Love does not brag, and is not arrogant. Does not act unbecomingly. It does not seek its own. Is not provoked. Love does not take into account the wrong suffered. Does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices with the truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails, but now faith, hope, and love abide these three. But the greatest of these is love. Oftentimes, about this time in the ceremony, you just want to kind of stop it, and you two guys probably want to say just, phew. Yes. I knew you did. And this last month, as we've talked, I know the last month especially has been very hectic. But God has blessed us for a good day for a wedding. God has blessed us with a good place for a wedding, his house. We're able to meet and get together a few times over the past couple of months, and I've gotten to know both of you a little bit better than I did. Two people grew up in different families, different backgrounds, different traditions. Both grew up in Massachusetts, 25 miles apart, never met each other, but God had a plan. Weddings are a good time to remember. The first time you met. Because you worked at the Blue Jeans. Scott noticing her, but very slow. It's a good time to remember when you spoke to each other for the first time. A good time to remember when you declared your love to each other for the first time. All the weddings are a good opportunity to look ahead to the future. You come this afternoon as two people, each with your own family, but you will leave as one, Mr. and Mrs., and you will leave as kids of a new family. God said, it is not good for man to be alone. A man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery. Come as two, and leave as one. Matthew 19:6, Jesus said, so they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. You ought to refer to marriage as holy matrimony. It is holy, because it is set apart. It is something deserving of reverence, because God is God. And as we gather here today, we celebrate because God is. And the glue, the adhesive that binds marriage together is love. Love for each other and love for Jesus Christ. You come this day declaring your love for each other. 1 Corinthians 13 is a good description, a good text to set before you that for this day. It tells us what love is, what it is not. True love. Love is not based on circumstances, it's not based on a mood, it's not based on an attitude. But it's a love based on commitment. It's a love that grows no matter whether it's hard times or easy times. It's a kind of love that requires work. Especially when those times come and you get on each other's nerves. It is a love that describes that it's deep and lasting. It's a love that trusts and forgives. It's a love that requires us to be open and honest. It's a love that requires us to admit fault. And a love that requires us to to allow God to create such a love in your family. A love that will allow you the courage and desire to create a beautiful and God-filled marriage. A marriage that blesses others and brings glory to God. Always remember, to have the best kind of marriage, it takes the involvement of three people. It's a man, it's a woman, and it's God. It is God who provides that move, that reason, to secure the marriage. God will sustain you through all the ups, and all the downs, all the trials, and all the temptations. God loves you. And in fact, God loves every one of us. As we gather here today, we celebrate Him. And in fact, God loved us so much that He promised us in His Word. He said, "For God so loved the world that He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." That's our celebration. When we put our faith in Jesus Christ, not only does He become part of our home, but we become part of His. I pray that as your love for each other grows, that your love for Jesus Christ will grow as well. God bless you. Scott and Chrissy have chosen their own vows today. So Scott, repeat after me. I promise before God, and all those gathered here, to commit myself to learning and living a life of love together with you. To that end, I promise to believe in you, comfort you, walk beside you, and to live every day as your steady and ever-present friend. On the days when being human, I am not able to meet these standards, I promise always to try. Believing that the love we share is uniquely created by God to be a love that never ends, I hereby promise you everything I have and everything I am for all of this human life. I promise before God and all those gathered here to commit myself to learning and living a life of love together with you. To that end, I promise to believe in you, comfort you, walk beside you, and to live every day as your steady and ever-present friend. On the days when, being human, I am not able to meet these standards, I promise always to try. Believing that the love we share is uniquely created by God to be a love that never ends, I hereby promise you everything I have and everything I am for all of this human life. Sacred covenant. These rings appear to be made of gold or silver. or force to fit your finger. And a circle has no beginning, it has no end. And while your relationship has had a beginning somewhere in the past, we pray that it will go on into the future. Let's pray. Heavenly Father God, I ask that you bless these rings, that as Scott and Chrissy wear them, that they may abide in your peace and continue in your faith. May they externally symbolize the love they have for each other in their covenant of marriage. In Jesus' name I pray. We are committed here today to share the rest of your lives with each other. We have witnessed your giving and received your rings and the exchange of vows. Now we will observe and create a lasting visual representation of these promises. Christian, your sand represents all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. Scott, your sand represents all that you were, and all that you are, and all that you will ever be. Your relationship is symbolized at the point of these two individual containers of sand is one. You will note that the individual colors do not cease to exist, but there are those times when the two are blended. It is this blending that is marriage. Sacred promises, you have exchanged rings. So it is with great joy that I announce to all your relatives and friends that are gathered here and to the world out there that you are joined in holy wedlock and that you have become the heirs of a brand new family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. God, you are the God of grace and of glory. God, you have brought together our families through this new covenant, to move into a great new adventure together. God, I pray that you would send your blessing not only upon this couple, but also upon those they are joining together. May their days be filled with joy and with love. May the challenges be lifted up to you, and may the love shining forth from this family be felt by all. Bless Scott and Christy in this marriage and all who support them. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Scott, you've been very patient. Let me kiss your bride. Go with God, that you may grow in this love all the days.